हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सुमिता गुप्ता. वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर माय 11th लेक्चर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस एंड सर्किट्स, दैट इज कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डीसी लोड लाइन, क्यू पॉइंट एंड रीजन ऑफ ऑपरेशन. सो आउटलाइंस फॉर टुडेज टॉपिक्स आर सीई एम्पलीफायर, दैट इज कॉमन एमिटर एम्पलीफायर, इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, डीसी लोड लाइन, देन कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ क्यू पॉइंट, देन रीजन ऑफ ऑपरेशन. So first of all, CE amplifier. What do you mean by CE amplifier? If you remember my previous lecture, there are various classification of BJTs like common emitter, common base, common collector. So one of used amplifiers are CE amplifier. That is common emitter amplifier. Means emitter terminal common between base and collector. Okay. So emitter terminal is grounded. This is your common emitter amplifier. Now question is, why it is called amplifier? Why it is called amplifier? Because it works as an amplifier. Amplifier means whatever the input, output will be having larger magnitude than the input. We are doing some amplification, means enhancement, enhancement of the magnitude. So this is common emitter BJT amplifier. And which type of amplifier? If arrow is from base to emitter, means it is NPN. So it is common emitter BJT NPN amplifier. Common emitter means emitter is grounded. Emitter is common between base and collector terminal, right? And it behaves like an amplifier, means whatever your input, output will be maximum. Okay, output will be in greater in magnitude. So that is your common emitter amplifier. Okay. So now output characteristics. If you remember in my previous lecture of BJT input output characteristics, I have already explained how to get the output characteristics. Again, listen, see this circuit carefully. Output characteristics drawn between output voltage DCE and output current IC. And remember, at the time of output characteristics, your input current is constant, not voltage. Input current is constant. And when we draw input characteristics, it will be drawn between VBE, input voltage, and input current. So input characteristics drawn between IB and VBE. At that time, your output voltage will be constant. VC will be constant. Okay. If you remember, for output characteristics, if IC versus VCE, and if you remember, there are three reasons: cutoff, active, and saturation region. In starting, when input is zero, current also zero, some leakage currents are there. That particular region is called cutoff region. After some time, okay. Or we can say after cutting voltage, current start to increase, and after some time, current will be constant. Okay, that is for particular value of base current. If base current increases, so if you remember the formula of IC equals to beta into IB. IC equals to beta, that is current gain, into IB. So definitely, as per this expression, if IB increases, so then IC will also increase. So that's why this is IB increase, IC increase, then saturated, then constant. Okay. So this particular region is called active region. And this region is our saturation region. Okay. So again, listen carefully. This region is cutoff, this region is active, and this region is saturation. So pause the video for a second and think about, for amplification, CE amplifier will work in which region? Cutoff, active, or saturation region? So answer is, BJT as amplifier works in the active region. BJT as amplifier works in the active region. Now, next concept is load line. See in this figure, which is load line? This is your load line. So what do you mean by load line? Why it is called load line? How these points achieve? That is a question. This is the load line, a line drawn between point A and point B. How these points we get? So answer is, for see this diagram. Okay, in this diagram, how to how to obtain the equation of output current. Okay, suppose here the current IC is flowing here. Now if you will apply KVL in this circuit, okay, simple trick I am telling you, this is BCE plus minus, this is called BCE. If we will apply the KVL, remember, for simplicity, I am moving from here to here. So I am moving from minus sign. So I'll write here minus BCC. That is a small trick. Okay. Minus sign, I am entering into minus sign, so I am taking minus. Now current is coming in this side, so definitely it will be plus, we'll assume. Okay, in the minus. Remember, in resistance, there is no plus minus. That depends on the direction of current. So I'm taking this current. So I'm entering to plus region. So at where I'll write plus. Now voltage across, it will be IC into RC. The voltage will be IC into RC. IC, RC. Okay. Now again, here plus minus BC. So I'm entering to plus. That's why I'll take plus BC. E equals to zero. That is a equation in the outer loop. Again, remember, I am entering to minus, minus BCC, I am entering plus, plus ICRC, I am entering plus, plus BC equals to zero. Okay, now if you remember, output characteristics drawn between IC and BC. So this is the relation between IC and BC. Okay. Now, as per this equation, I'll find out what is the value of IC. IC will be equals to, from this equation, if you will solve this equation, IC will be VCC minus ICRC. Sorry, one second. If I'll find out the IC in this equation, in this equation, then BCC will be on right side. So BCC minus BC. Okay. BC minus. So ICRC equals to IC equals to BCC minus BCE. And RC will be divided. So BCC upon RC and BC upon RC. So if we'll compare this equation with y equals to mx plus c, so it is an equation of a straight line. Okay, that's why this load line is straight line. If we'll compare the equation with y equals to mx plus c, so this will be a straight line. Okay, now what will the concept? If you remember the two points, BC is your x-axis, IC your y-axis. So this 1 upon RC is amp, slope. Because VCC upon RC is a constant term. Okay, again listen. Your equation is VCC upon RC. This is your constant term. Okay, VCC is supply or RC is often constant term. So main X and Y is IC and VC. So what is amp? 1 upon RC. So slope is your 1 upon RC. So RC is a constant. And this RC is basically your load. See the circuit? RC is your load. RC is your load. So slope is proportional to the load. That's why it's called load line. And that load is of DC, not AC, because it's a constant. So that's why it's this is called DC load line. That's why this is called DC load line. Now question is how to achieve point A, point B. To see this equation, I have already explained you how to get the equation. In this equation, if I put current is zero. For point A, I am taking point A means this point. So for this point, BC I have to take in zero. So if BC equals to zero in this equation, so what will happen? 0 equals to VCC minus IC. So IC equals to VCC upon RC. See, remember, there are two points, X point, Y point. X point is your BC and Y point is your current IC. Okay. So I want to get the point x when y zero or y when x zero. So I am taking first bc zero. If bc zero, then ic is bcc upon rc. So this point is bcc upon rc. Next point is point b. So for point b, I am taking ic zero. If this ic zero, the bc equals to bcc. So see here, bc equals to bcc. Okay, so these are the points. Okay, when bc zero, I equals to bcc upon rc. When I zero, bc equals to bcc. When we join these two points, we got the load line, and that load line depends on dc load, hence it's called dc load line. Okay, so this is the concept of dc load line. So next is, what is Q point and what are the operating points? Okay, so if we assume VCC and RC constant, then all the value of IC and DC will intersect on DC load line are called operating points. Means simple, you can say this is your output characteristics and this is your load line. This intersection is called your Q point, but that depends on different, because means we get output characteristics for different values of IB. So this point is also Q point, this point is also Q point. If I'll take the output characteristics like this, this point is also Q point. These are various Q point. Okay, and the current at this board, Q point will be IC current, IC Q1 current, VC Q1 voltage. Current across Q2 will be Q2 current and Q2 voltage. Current across Q3 is the Q3 current and Q3 voltage. Okay, because DC load line is fixed. DC load line is fixed and slope of DC load line is minus 1 by RC. But Q points are different. So our next question is, how to select Q point? So there are various reasons. Q point, we can take near cutoff reason, near saturation reason, and near active reason. So first condition, if you remember the characteristics, suppose this is our characteristics and this is your load line. Okay, and I have already explained you the three reasons. So this particular reason is our cutoff reason. Okay, and this is reason is saturation reason. Okay, and if we'll take this particular reason from here to here is our active reason. Okay, now for example, we are taking the Q point in near this reason. This reason is cutoff reason. So if you remember this, we are taking Q point. Okay, and this Q point, take three points. One point for voltage, input voltage, one for output current, output voltage. Now if you draw the full cycle, this will be your input voltage. This is your output voltage, and this is your output current. So see, in this particular diagram, if you check this, positive side is clear. But in negative side, this particular portion is coming under the cutoff reason. This is coming, this particular reason is clipping, because actual load line is basically between active reason. See here. Okay, actual load line is active reason. See, this positive part is perfect in active reason, but in negative part, this portion is clipped. This portion coming in this cutoff reason. Same here, positive part is whole, but in negative part coming this in cutoff reason. Same here, output current, positive part is okay, but this negative part, this portion is clipped. Okay, so positive part we are getting okay, but negative peak is clipped. So we can't take Q point near the cutoff reason. Now the next idea is, if we take Q point near saturation reason, we have taken Q point here. Last time we have taken Q point here. Again, take three points, one point here, and one point here. Now draw this is your input voltage. This is your output voltage, and this is your output current. And now see clearly. Okay, if we'll take only this reason, active reason. So what will happen? Now positive part is clipped. That is coming in this saturation reason. In this also, this positive part is clipped. This positive part come in this reason. And in this case, this positive part is coming in this reason. So ultimately, positive peak gets clipped. We are not getting perfect output. Okay, we are not getting the perfect output. See clearly here, positive peak clipped. Here also positive peak clipped. Here also positive peak clipped. So if we take Q point near saturation region, then positive peak will be clipped. Now the third idea is, if we take in exactly Q point in the active region, in the middle, center of load line. So if we draw the input voltage, output voltage, output current, now see, positive part is perfect, negative part is perfect. We are getting the full, if input is full, then output is full. Output voltage and output current is also full. So there is nothing clipping. So what is the final idea? Q point should be in active region and it should be in center of DC load line. That is the selection of Q point. Thank you so much. If you like, please like and subscribe my channel. Keep learning. God bless you.